Hi everyone. In the last class, I just given slight introduction about the symmetry and symmetry in the molecules, where we discussed the what is the equivalent structure, what is the identical structure, and where we also given some important important things to remember in while we are doing the symmetry operations. That is 3 points. One is knowing the molecular geometry, knowing the stereochemistry of the molecule, and the second thing is the holding of molecules in a proper way we have to do while we do symmetry analysis on molecule, and third thing is we should not to be disturb the gravity point of the molecule while we do the symmetry operations on molecule, right? Thus slight introduction I given, right? Now, while we continue the same symmetry in molecule chapter in next videos, I here want to explain you symmetry operation, right? So in the last class, doing rotation on water molecule, we done, where the rotation will be called as symmetry operation, right? Not only rotation, there are different types of symmetry operations are there. So exactly what are the definition of symmetry operation and what are the different symmetry operations are there, now I would like to explain you. Here in definition of symmetry operation, a geometry exercise on molecule, that is rotation or reflection or inversion or rotation followed by reflection, right? To generate equivalent or identical structures will be known as symmetry operations, right? It is a geometry exercise, right? Geometry exercise on molecule. The geometry exercises like rotation or reflection or inversion or rotation followed by reflection, where these exercises, when they are generating equivalent structure or identical structure, either it is equivalent or identical structure when generates, thus particular geometry exercise will be called as symmetry operation. So doing that on what we take is ammonia. Here I would like to change the example. In the previous example I taken in water, na? Here I will take ammonia, right? So to have on ammonia, right, we have to know the geometry of the ammonia, geometry and atoms, stereochemistry of the ammonia we have to know, right, atom arrangement in three dimensional in ammonia we have to know, right? Ammonia, we know that it is an pyramidal shape, right? sp3 hybridized geometry, sp3 hybridized molecule it is, right? And a non-bonding electron pair on nitrogen will have pyramidal shape. In pyramidal shape, the atoms arrangement, nitrogen and hydrogen arrangements will be looks like this, right? Will look like this. Here in this, right, middle will be considered as nitrogen and the bottom four, three will be called as, considered as hydrogens, right? it would be at the top there is a nitrogen atom, in downward there are three hydrogen atoms and angularly down, right? In down one will be above and two will be below, one will be above and two will be below, angularly bonded towards the nitrogen, right? Nitrogen will be in top, three hydrogens are bounded angularly in the down, one will be above, two will be in below, right? That's how the pyramidal shape and atom arrangement in ammonia, right? So same that, right, if we do reverse it, right, if we do reverse it, what happens? In the down hydro, in the down nitrogen and three hydrogens are above, angularly in above, angularly above, one is towards you, two are in down, right? What we are saying, at the middle nitrogen, at the middle nitrogen, three are the hydrogen towards up and towards up and angularly bounded, right? Angularly bounded, right? So that's the model. Here we do write the structure, nitrogen and three hydrogens angularly bounded, and here we consider that they are in above, hydrogens are in the above, right? This on this molecule, right, we may have different operations, right? We can do either rotation, reflection or inversion, rotation followed by reflection, whatever we do. That's the operation when it is generating, right? Whatever we do, the geometry exercise of rotation, reflection or inversion or rotating, rotation followed by reflection, if it is generating equivalent structure or identical structure, then this particular geometry exercise, rotation or reflection or inversion or rotation followed by reflection, will be called as geometry operation, symmetry operation, right? So here on particular ammonia, right, I would like to do rotation, right? I would like to do rotation of 120 degrees, of 120 degrees, where the axis I would like to consider that which is, right, exactly passing through nitrogen, right, and middle of the three hydrogens, like this, right, like this, which is exactly middle of the nitrogen and passing in between of hydrogens, like this, right, which is passing middle of the nitrogen and passing exactly middle of the three hydrogens, right, like this, right. The imaginary axis is like this. What I hold the stick, that would be a imaginary axis with respect of that which is passing through nitrogen, right, and middle of the three hydrogens with respect of that, while I do the rotation of 120 degrees, right, 120 degrees, what the structure it is generating I would like to see, right? So here labeling of hydrogens H1, H2, H3, right? Not only numbering of labeling here, 1, 2, 3, we cannot take, we can change the numbering also, right? I take A, B, C, right? A, B, C, whatever the thing, P, Q, R, you can take, alpha, beta, gamma, you can take anything, any labeling you can do, right? So initially in the water, while I describing the symmetry in water, I taken 1, 2, no? Here in the ammonia, I am changing it as ABC, right? So taking that labeling of hydrogen and doing a rotation where the axis is exactly middle of the nitrogen and in between of three hydrogen, and doing 120 degrees rotation, right? What happens with the 120 degrees of rotation, right? Here the angle when we check between nitrogen to hydrogen, nitrogen hydrogen atom bonds of one to other, right, they are 120 degrees angularly separating the bonds, right? So while we do rotation of 120 degrees of angle rotation, the one of the NH bond will be replaced by another one NH bond, right? So here like this, right? So here the hydrogen H1, this HA, HB, HC, and axis is this. And here angles, when we consider this particular angle is 120, this is an angle 120, this is 120 angle. while we do rotation of 120 degrees of angle, where I take the axis which is passing through nitrogen, right, middle of the nitrogen, just replace the one of the hydrogen by other, right, like this, right. Here H1 it is there initially, sorry, HA it is there, thus HA, right, HA, HB, HC. While we do rotation, right, what happening? HA is going towards the HC position, HB is going towards the HA position, HC is going towards the HB position, right. So thus it is happening. Is that nitrogen position is changing? While we do rotation, right, this is H1, HA, HB, HC. This is nitrogen. While as we taken the axis through the nitrogen, is the nitrogen position is changing? No. It is never changes the nitrogen position. Whereas the hydrogen positions, yeah, thus the hydrogen positions are changed, right. H1 is, HA is replaced by HB, HB is replaced by HC, and HC is replaced by HA, right. Nitrogen position is not changing, it means that center of gravity is not changed, right. That is where we have to be very cautious. Center of gravity point should not be changed. Yeah, it is not changing nothing but the operation what we do is correct, right. So HA is going towards the HC. So here HA will come. HC will going towards the HB. Here HB, HC will come. And HB is going towards the HA position. Here HB will come, right. So HB will go HA position, HA will come. HC position, HC will come, HB position, right. This is how, right. So the this is original what we consider. This is original geometry what we considered, right. After doing 180 degrees of rotation where the axis passing through nitrogen, right, is when we compare with original structure, previous structure what we consider, right. This is pyramidal, this is also pyramidal. The shape of the geometry is change, or is the shape of the geometry is changing, right. While we do rotation, right, is the shape of the geometry is changing? No, right. The shape of the geometry is same, pyramidal, right. And the nitrogen position is not changing, where the hydrogens are just replaced by one to other, just replaced by one to other, right. After this hydrogen position change, right, if we do absent the labeling of hydrogen, they would be one and same. But when we label the hydrogens, right, they are different, right. So when this could be said as, right, not exactly 100% same, it is similar structure. So this similar structure when will be called equivalent structure, equivalent configuration, right. So while we do geometry exercise, if it is generating equivalent structure or identical structure, equivalent configuration or identical configuration, then this particular geometry operation will be called as symmetry operation. So now the rotation about 120 degrees in the ammonia will be a symmetry operation. In the ammonia, the rotation of 120 degrees of angle while the axis is passing through only nitrogen, right, will be a symmetry operation, right. So continuing of this particular operation, doing another time 120 degrees of rotation, right, will generates, what it generates? So what is the change while we observe in the first rotation? Similar change will be observed, right. So nitrogen position never be changed. Hydrogen positions, yeah, thus the hydrogen positions will change, but the change will that the one of the hydrogen is replaced by one other hydrogens will be get replaced, right. So the HA will come in HC position, right, and HC will go in HB position, HB will come in HC position, right, HB here, right, like this, right. H will come here, HB, HA will come here, HC will come here, right. So again, when we compare these two structure, again, this is an equivalent configuration only, equivalent configuration. So another time doing same rotation of 120, same the pyramidal shape of the ammonia will be सेम नाइट्रोजन पोजिशन विल बी सेम, सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी पोजिशन विल बी सेम, वेयर द HA विल कम इन टॉप, HC विल कम इन HB पोजिशन, HB विल बी कम इन HA पोजिशन, हियर HB, राइट. सो व्हाइल वी कंपेयर द जनरेटेड कॉन्फिगरेशन विथ ओरिजिनल कॉन्फिगरेशन, दिस इज ए आइडेंटिकल कॉन्फिगरेशन. Even the labeling will be have similar, right? Even the labeling will never be distinguished these two structures as say different. Even the labeling, it will be same structure, 100% same structure. So far it will be called as identical geometry, identical configuration, right? So that is how the symmetry operation, same, even if we do the reflection or inversion or reflection followed by rotation, if they are generating similar, equivalent or identical structure, they are also called as symmetry operations in ammonia molecule. Symmetry operations, what we do is, right, with the help of three rules what we have in the previously in the first lecture, I express you the three rules, right. What is the three rules? The geometry of the molecule, the stereochemistry of the molecule, the atomic arrangement in the molecular geometry should be exactly known to you, right. The second thing is holding the molecular model should be in proper way, right. The second thing, and the third thing is the center of gravity point should not to be changed, right. So let us examine those three also once, right. For that I would like to take a water molecule where we know the water molecule geometry, right. It is an angular. So angular atom, angular water molecule while we consider, and here taking an molecular model, right, and doing a rotation, right, doing a rotation should to be in proper angle and proper axis we have to consider. When we do not consider the proper angle or proper axis, it never results a symmetry analysis, perfect symmetry analysis. It leads to a errors in the symmetry analysis, right. So taking here an axis which is passing through oxygen atom and doing 180 degrees of rotation, right, what happens is here is this particular rotation generates equivalent structure, right, never be, right. Why you may say that while do axis, taking an axis which is horizontally passing through oxygen atom, right, while it do the rotation, what happens is the oxygen position may not be changes, but the hydrogen positions from the down they reaches to up. The hydrogen will go here, the H2 will come here, right, just go downward to upward. This particular, right, geometries never be considered as the generated configuration never be considered as equivalent or identical. Since why? Because while we do take the oxygen, right, what I told you that in equivalent structure or identical structure, right, while we do generate the equivalent structure, right, from here to here, ammonia when we observe, what happening? The similar atoms are getting, exchanging their position to generate equivalent or identical structure. When similar atoms are never exchanges, right, then it never be leads to a equivalent or identical structure, right. So here doing a, while taking a water molecule and taking an axis which is horizontal, right, and doing the rotation of 180, right, this is 180 degrees of rotation, right. So in before, this is what we have, H1, H2 in the downward. While we do rotation of 180, what happening? They are going upward. This is a total different structure what we consider. Initially what we consider? A water molecule which is angular in topward, in this particular shape, topward oxygen, downward hydrogens, right, and one is left hydrogen, another is right hydrogen, right. But after getting 180 degrees of rotation with the axis which is passing through horizontal towards the oxygen, right, it is generating this particular structure. In this particular structure, the oxygen is downward now, the hydrogen is upward, right. So thus change makes that lot change, which could not be said that this particular generated configuration never be considered as equivalent or identical structure, right. So while we do take the axis which is passing vertically from the oxygen, if the axis vertically passing, right, and do rotate the 180 degree same rotation, right. So here again, before going the rotation, the structural aspects when we consider, this is angular shape water molecule, topward oxygen, downward two hydrogens, one is left, another is right, right. After getting rotation of 180 degrees, right, what happening, even after getting 180 degrees rotation, the oxygen is in the topward, the geometry of the molecule is same angular, and topward oxygen, downward hydrogen, left side is one, right side is one, right. So before to after, right, before is this, after rotation is this, where the geometry is not changing, right, V shape is not changing, even though the atom positions, right, the atom hydrogens are down, oxygen is top, right. That's how the comparison can be happen, and similar atoms, right, the hydrogen, left side hydrogen of H1 and H2, when we consider, they are just replacing one to other, right. While doing that similar atom replacement, where it will be gives you identical or equivalent structure, right. When the similar atoms are just when replaces one by other, right, it generates the equivalent structure or identical structure, where the here in the scenario of this particular rotation, right, the hydrogens are replaced an empty space, right. While we do 180 degrees rotation by taking axis horizontally, right, through the oxygen atom, where the hydrogens are replaced an empty space, and the hydrogen position becoming empty here. After getting rotation, the hydrogen positions here getting empty, where hydrogens are getting replaced in an empty space, right. This particular change never be considered for the equivalent structure or identical structure, right. So that's how this particular rotation never be called as symmetry operation, right. Well, it is generating equivalent or identical structure only, then this particular geometry axis, even it is rotation, reflection or inversion, will be considered as symmetry operation. This could not be considered as a symmetry operation, okay. So that is how, and while we do symmetry geometry exercises such as rotation, the rotation will be considered with respect of an axis, right. Through an axis we do rotation, whereas reflection, when we do the reflection through a plane, we do with the help of plane, right. And when we do inversion with a point, through a point we do the inversion, right. So doing operations of rotation, reflection, inversion with the help of axis, plane or point we do, right. So that's how the rotation, reflection, inversions as a symmetry operations. Symmetry element can be defined as a symbolic representation of symmetry operation. A symbolic representation of symmetry operation. Will be known as symmetry element. Right. Here we have five symmetry elements. In that, first one will be rotational axis where this particular rotational axis, the operation will be rotation. So operation will be rotation, and it is symbolized as Cn. It is symbolized as Cn. The second symmetry element is plane of symmetry. Plane of symmetry. The symmetry operation here it is reflection. Doing reflection on molecules will be considered as plane of symmetry element, which is symbolized with sigma. The third symmetry element is improper axis of symmetry. Here the operation is rotation followed by reflection. Or reflection followed by rotation. Right. Rotation followed by reflection or reflection followed by rotation. We do two operations here. Rotation and reflection. Right. The sequence of rotation reflection can be changed. Right. Either you can do first rotation followed by reflection. Or you do reflection and thus it followed by rotation. Whatever we do the sequence of rotation, doing two things, rotation reflection, will be known as improper axis of symmetry and symbolized with Sn. Right. And this improper axis is also called as rotation reflection axis or reflection rotation axis. Also called as rotation reflection axis or reflection rotation axis or reflection rotation axis. Right. The fourth element is inversion center or center of inversion or center of inversion. Where the symmetry operation is inversion. Here the symbolic representation is small i we can consider here. Right. And the fifth last symmetry element, but not the least, which is called as symmetry element, will be called as identity. Identity, where what we the symmetry operation is 360 degrees of rotation or 0 degrees of rotation. Which is symbolized with E, capital E. Right. 360 degrees of rotation or 0 degrees of rotation, nothing but doing a complete rotation or doing nothing. Right. 0 degrees of rotation, nothing but you don't do anything. Right. You cannot do anything. Right. 180 degrees of rotation, nothing but a complete rotation. Right. Whatever we do, complete rotation when we do or doing nothing will result in an identical configuration of the molecule, and that particular symmetry operation will be symbolized with capital E, and this will be known as identity, symmetry element of identity. Okay. So like this we have the five symmetry elements. The symmetry operation when we symbolically represent it is called as symmetry element, and there are five: rotation axis of symmetry symbolized with Cn, doing rotation as a symmetry operation; plane of symmetry symbolized with sigma, doing reflection symmetry operation; improper axis of symmetry symbol is Sn, doing rotation and reflection one after the other; the fourth is inversion center or center of inversion will be symbolized with small I. Here we do the inversion of atom positions, right, inversing the atom position; and fifth is identity symbolized with capital E, doing rotation, doing 360 degrees of rotation or 0 degrees of rotation, doing complete a cycle of rotation or doing nothing is identity, right? Thank you.